Yes, hi, and it's all my fault. I mean, the entire podcast is my fault, but today it's my fault. We're running a little late. I'm in a lot of pain. I took the second vaccine. Okay, there's no pain really, but it's a little swelly. And I'm the kind of person who feels pain even before. I anticipate pain a lot. Very often I don't even get the pain, but I anticipate it. It's like exactly like marriage. What I always dreamed marriage would be. You know, the moment it happened, I felt more pain, but before that I was feeling the pain as well. But I'm two shots down, which in the old days would be Friday night, but today it's, what is it, Tuesday evening, 6:30. So missed the morning because of the shot. That was the slot we were given by our Prime Minister and Chief Minister, who came together just for me. And we're going to do an AMA special to make up for this. We have a guest scheduled, but he's under a lot of pressure doing a lot of different things. A very important personality. If he comes on, great. If he doesn't, the show must go on because you, the viewer, the podcast consumer, are more important than anybody else. I mean, that's a lot of bullshit, but we have to say it so that people show interest. Let's invite the one and only young Mr. Silvery, who's somewhere there by the light of Hello. The silvery moon. There he is.
Hey.
Silvery, what an emergency today for us, man. I mean, we had to change from morning to evening. We had to change the time from 6 to 6:30. You've been under the cosh, as they say. It's been a bad, bad day. And,
And then guest, the guest is not in on time after all of that.
Not in on time, and we can't call. I mean, he's got an important set of things going on in his life, so we can't even say, boss, our podcast. To be honest, can't even be angry with the guest because our podcast is so insignificant. It's like a band-aid against cancer. You know, I mean, it's like you can't even talk about it from that perspective. What a terrible analogy. I apologize again, but I'm still reeling from Conan, you know, running away like that. And then this.
Man.
By the way, I had a great experience, Silvery, in the morning. Parsi General, parking everywhere you want. Beautiful. If you've ever been there, unlike any of the Indian hospitals around, it's like a big bungalow. It's like a big fort. It's just fabulous and it's just lovely. You feel like you're in a really old hotel in Rajasthan. And you go in and there's lots of space. There's no rushing. I was out in 10-15 minutes. It was superb. There were three very pretty nurses. Not that that's important. But you know, if it's I'll tell you why I say this. I always worry if it's the last face you ever see when you take an injection and suppose something bad happened. And the last face you... By the way, the last face I'm going to see is Jitin's. And he's joining
me
from Lunavala.
Hello.
From
not Lunavala, man. No, man. I'm at Himachal Dalhousie.
Dalhousie? While rest of India is suffering in this terrible pandemic, you're holidaying away. What are you using?
Not holidaying, man. I've been working hard here for last 2 months. It's just that Jitin, I get the luxury of seeing a little bit of greenery, Cyrus.
It looks lovely, Baba. It looks like you're having a great time. I want to just tell the people who are listening, but we weren't sure if you're joining. This is our esteemed guest, Jitendra Gupta. He's worth something close to $36 trillion, which is what China owes the world for the pandemic per day. He is the founder and CEO of Jupiter, India's first digital banking app, co-created with a community. He'll tell us all about that in a minute. Jitin's previous venture was Citrus Pay, a successful online payments company that was sold to Naspers in 2016. He then went on to become, listen to this guys, MD of PayU India, where he launched, I'm sure everyone remembers this, Lazy Pay, a pay later product, which I'm told my producer will join us in 20 minutes on the show. He's very grateful for that product because apparently he just he had an outstanding of 4 or 5 grand, not a lot. But he just wouldn't pay. And you guys, your guys were very gentle with him. They would call up and say, sir, koshish to karlo. Try karo, effort to karlo. It was more those kind of words. There was no, you know, dhamki and overriding guys in long kurtas coming with sticks or something. There's nothing like that. So he was just telling me he loved that app. And and then of course, you spent 7.5 years at ICICI, commerce graduate and chartered accountant, Jitendra Gupta, also known as Jiten. Welcome to our horrible show. From all the way from Dalhousie. And I know you're very busy,
Cyrus.
So thank you for taking the time. Yeah.
No, great to meet you. It's sort of pleasure to talk to you one-on-one. I have seen you on TV and radio and where all. But great to see you in person right now.
Although, Jitin, if you saw me on radio, then you're a bigger genius than anybody else. I have to tell you. That's an audio medium.
No, but I mean to say the audio, so that's...
Sir, I'm just being what is called... there's a word in Punjabi which rhymes with fruit and starts with C. That's part of my personality and I apologize for that. I want to start with some general questions also before we get into your career and all. It's very interesting. Firstly, Jitin, you're very young. Okay, we didn't realize how young you are. You're a really super successful man at a very young age, which included 7.5 years paying, learning the trade, if you want, in ICICI. It doesn't really count because you're, you know, the genius part of you and the success part of you comes after that. But right in the beginning, I want to just ask a couple of general questions. What is the what is the mood like right now for India? I've got the economic times in front of me, and it's given me all kinds of negative connotation in the front page of Better Stuff and the back pages. So I was just asking you, as an entrepreneur first, and as a person who studies markets all the time, where do we stand? FPIs, DIIs fall to 15-year low. Things looking bleak.
Yeah, I mean, Cyrus, if you ask me, there are two parts of India I'm seeing right now being an entrepreneur. So one part, which is this whole crazy startup world, which is like, I must say, seeing the all-time high. And nothing seems to be impacting here because all the businesses have gone digital on internet and all. So, I think all the businesses are doing amazingly well, I would say. And the second part of the India, which is like, literally the brick and mortar India where the real business happens and the real interaction happens. And I think that part is like literally very grim. And, you know, I've been on the road for the last 2 months. And the situation is like really bad. People sort of telling their sad stories, how their businesses got shut down and how they're impacted by COVID. And I must say, I think we, the startup guys, are in our own cocoon and didn't realize the situation is so bad because we are seeing only things going great in last 2 years from a business side. So it's a real revelation to me personally.
Wow. So what you're saying is that dependence on digital, because of the pandemic in a sense, has pushed the digital people, players ahead and the entrepreneurs ahead who are looking to do startups and stuff because the market is actually bigger for them. But we look at sector by sector, things are not looking good at all. And will we recover? I was talking to friends in the hospitality sector, for example, and these are well educated and rich guys. They are not even struggling and they are unable to hold and sustain the loans they have and the sort of, you know, the payment to staff and just the basic, you know, amenities that they have to pay for. They can't run these places, 3 and 4 restaurants at a time. It's just getting completely out of control. So, I mean, if you look at sector by sector, some of them are looking really bad.
Yeah, you are right, Cyrus. Some of them are like really bad, though. Thankfully, the hospitality seems to be picking up in last 1 month. As I said, you know, I've been out.
Because
and,
you've gone to Dalhousie and booked the whole hotel. You've done your bit, sir, to save the country. Aap to deshbhakt hai, bhai.
So, but booking nahi mil raha hai, yaar. So, when I'm trying to book.
You're joking or serious?
I'm serious. I'm trying to book my next week's booking and people are saying we are fully booked until end of July and this is crazy. So I would say...
Paisa nahi hai, toh, chutti ke liye kaun jaate hai? I mean, it doesn't make any sense, yaar.
But I must say, the Indian consumers have now kind of tired of lockdown and they have given up. And they're saying, boss, abhi ho gaya bahut, vaccine bhi lag gaya hai, abhi chalo bahar. So I think that is what it is happening. And I can see the real crowd on the roads now and everything seems to be booked here.
Well, that's a good sign, is it not? And what do you think that people are going to be like a revolution? Ki hum log to kaam karna padega and karna hai and we have to feed our families and that's it?
Yeah, I think... So, you know, I see the positive side, if you ask me, where this never dies spirit, where you're like, boss, whatever is going on, it's okay. We got to move on in the life. And I think that is the spirit which I'm seeing. And in last 1 month specifically, where people have come out, people are taking precaution as well. I have seen people are not acting negligent like way they were acting last year after the initial wave. So there is an adequate balance which is being striked and people are living a life in the given circumstances way better than last year.
Jitin, two things before we get into your career, I want to ask you. One thing, of course, is we at the podcast have been working very hard in these terrible conditions. We sit in our air-conditioned rooms and we make sure that the show goes on the air. With a lot of risk to ourselves from, you know, relatives who may or may not pass. But more importantly, I want to ask you, how do you do normal things during the lockdown? Like, I've got this long toenail. My wife saying, ki, abhi kuch to karo, and I can't reach it and she refuses to cut it. So, how have you dealt with those kind of things?
So, you know, I must say, fortunately, my wife has been supporting me heavily where I just locked myself.
Already so, criticizing my family.
Yeah. So I just locked my, before coming to Himachal, I used to lock myself in the room. 9 to 6, I was just in the room behaving like this is the office day. Saturday, Sunday, properly giving time to the family. So my wife is like, we never felt it's pandemic. You are treating us exactly like only weekend time available to the family. Weekdays not available. So I think that. But that routine.
Are you serious? You actually sat in the room like 9 to 6.
I am serious. And my lunch used to come in the room.
People
itself.
Are
I'm not
drawing inspiration from you. So everyone's going to write down and say secret to success. Jitin ye karta, main bhi karunga. And so it makes a lot of sense. A lot of people. I hope will start doing that.
But I tell you, it took some bit of toll and I went mad, and that's how I don't know, while sitting in the room also I got COVID. So, I don't know from where.
An app. It has to be one of the apps.
It has to be the app or audio stream. I must have done one of the podcasts. I'm sure.
Oh, this is a fascinating point. A lot of people tell me the same thing. Kisi ka physical contact na hone ki wajah se fir bhi, how did it happen?
Yeah, so I had zero clue how I got it, but I saw this as a blessing though. I'm like, boss, I'm safe for next 3 months, and this is a time I can go out and enjoy the nature. So this is how I decided to come to Himachal and work from here.
Wow. I'm already feeling, you know, quite jealous, firstly, because I think you just got a positive idea about everything. And by taking a positive geographic location is probably, you know, the what we call the Shakti, the internal sort of energy that, you know, just goes into a more positive. Because if you notice, the whole world is very negative at the moment. Lots of people, only negative conversation. And it's simply, open India.
I agree. And I think that's what I'm saying. You know, I'm seeing the similar change in consumers now where people are saying, boss, whatever has happened is fine. We can't get stuck in our life. We got to move on. Yeah. And I think that is the great thing which I feel about all of us. Yes, we did foolishness last year. But now there is adequate caution and the balance.
Yeah. Well, let's now get back to the career of Jitendra Gupta, because that's why he's here, not to just give us gyan on everything else, but more importantly about his life story, which will inspire millions of people to become the next big thing in startups. By the way, startups wise, we are still doing well in terms of numbers, right?
Well, yeah. I mean, of course, there were casualties last year, but more than casualties, more new startups came. So I think we are fine in my view.
Okay. Can we go right to the beginning of your, it looks like a normal sort of commerce and CA and was your calling. And then you went to ICICI.
Yeah, I worked at ICICI during the time when ICICI was actually bringing the whole retail banking revolution to India way back in 2003. So the bank had just started the retail banking operation. So I joined at that time, and I must say it was one of the best time I had because it was one of the craziest time in the sense the growth rates were like every month you got to do double of what you were doing last month. And you know, I was like, As a fresh air, when I come and I'm like, are these guys crazy? What these guys are talking? And you know, somehow we used to still meet the numbers. And I'm like, wow, this is something to learn. And so much of autonomy, so much of learning. So that was the best part of the career, the professional job career, I would say. And that's how I sticked around for 7.5 years there.
Double targets every month sounds like BJP's program in West Bengal. Of course, they didn't meet it, but they also tried it. But let's understand from the common man's point of view. So you were there when Amitabh is the brand ambassador or Shah Rukh is the brand ambassador?
Amitabh and Shah Rukh both, actually.
Wow. So you saw the best of both worlds.
Yeah, we saw the best of both.
So the young Jitendra at that point is meeting targets and playing the role of a proper banker. Of course, the retail banking being new, etc., etc. But when did the idea to do something on your own and something different, how did that happen?
So, you know, Cyrus, my last stint in the bank, my last couple of years was in the payment strategy team at the bank. And that's when I realized that, you know, what bank is doing is fine. But I think the customers, which is the merchants who are accepting payments, their issues are still not being looked by the bank in an optimal manner in which they expect. And I think after a lot of internal debates and relations...
Can you explain that a little bit? You mean the payment?
payments. Yeah. So if you look at, let's say, Make My Trip. Now, Make My Trips, I still remember we spoke to...
Gali dena padega.
Yeah. We spoke to these guys. And these guys were like, you know, guys, your payment gateway is down half of the time. And you're like, yeah, we are a bank. Sometimes we do maintenance of the system. So it is okay. They're saying, what, it is okay. We can't afford even a 1 minute downtime. And you were saying 6 hour downtime, 8 hour downtime without notice. So, you know, I realized that the expectation of the merchants, which is this Make My Trips or the Yatras and all of the JetAways and all, were very, very different as compared to what we as a bank were delivering. In terms of the reliability, uptime, success rates of the payment transactions and all of that. And I'm like, there needs to be dedicated focus, investment into technology, which needs to be delivered. And that's how this whole thing came up. And 2010, I quit bank. And frankly, when I quit, I was like, there will something has to be done on this side. But I had zero idea how to start. But I thought,
but
till the
quit,
time I don't
you
quit.
You quit without the idea.
That's
you
right.
Quit without
that
the
is
idea.
A fact. Yeah, wow. That's the fact. Because, you know, because I have been planning to quit the bank since 2006 with various ideas. I planned. And at the last moment, you know, you have this bad habit of expecting your monthly pay. And I'm like, no, man, this, let me take this month's pay, then next month I'll decide. And that went on for 3 years. And after three and a half years of my mental debate, I realized no more. Let me quit first. And then figure out. So, when there is a fire, you will automatically know what to do next.
Okay, so just let's understand this again from your thinking or thinking of people who become successful like you. Is it true that if you don't make that just jump out of where you are, you actually never leave it? You know, it's
you know,
almost like...
you know, I would not do that craziness again. I think I was crazy. So maybe it
but
was
you weren't
the
scared.
Fact. Yeah, I maybe it was the age factor. I was 28 and I'm like, what I have got to lose? Nothing. Just my few years salary, which I'm okay. And I think that is what sort of gave me the courage that I'm okay to lose my 2 years of career.
But brother, biwi ne kya kaha? Family ne kya kaha? Mummy, daddy ne? I mean, come on. They must have CA.
So of course, wife was shocked when I told her that the day I came home and I told her that I resigned today. And then like, are you mad? Are you out of your mind? Why did you do this? And then I explained that, you know, I want to give myself 2 years. And they're saying we could have waited for the bonus to come in. Maybe, you know, this is the problem. This is the problem. So I left in December. The bonus comes in March. My God, this
what are
is
you
the problem.
Saying? Jiten, tune kya kiya? Of course, you made millions or more.
So I'm like, this is the problem. If you wait for bonus, then it will be like, yeah, I got the increment now. How can I leave? So I'm not going to do this. I actually want to, when I lose something, then I will know the importance of work. Like I got to deliver. And I think that is what I did. We did not tell our family for 6 months, by the way.
They so my you family, the bank.
Yeah, they thought I'm still working.
Wow.
So because it was a shock. Like we're talking not the startup world now. We're talking the when the startup world did not exist, 2010. So I think it would have been a big shock. My wife did not tell her parents. Otherwise, they would have been like under trauma.
Jiten, you had your first lockdown then only. There's a good chance. Yeah.
So actually, that's right. You know, I did not step out of the house for 3 months because I'm like, boss, if I step out of the house, I'm going to spend money and I'm going to spend extra. I don't have that much money to spend extra. I got to save for 2 years. So, you know, I was like in a literally conserve mode.
Nee, but you didn't, you had an idea or you did not have an idea then? I understood the idea ki mujhe kuch karna hai, yeh nahi karna hai, mujhe aur kuch karna hai. That's clear. But you jumped out of the bank. You're a guy with a good academic record from a proper, you know, our middle class background and all that. You know what I'm saying? It's amazing. It's for us, for our people to behave
it's
like
craziness.
That.
It's
like you're drunk or something. You know, we can't explain that.
Yes, it was craziness. Frankly, when we cherish those moments now, but when we sort of discuss between myself and my wife, and we are like, you know, how did we manage to behave so crazy? But yeah, that craziness now when I look back was worth it. So, but yes, we did not have I did not have the idea when I quit the bank. I was like, I'll figure it out. in next 6 months, what I have to do.
You sound like a politician. मुझे सीट चाहिए, फिर सोच आगे वो आगे करते हैं. Wow. But I don't fully believe you. I mean, I'm not disrespecting you, but I can't believe that there was no, because you had your ideas in your head. I think you didn't have a clear path yet. You didn't have a capital sort of, you know, your sidekick or whatever, but I'm sure there were some ideas fermenting.
Cyrus, I'm not joking. This is the fact. When I quit, the day I quit, I was clueless what I'm going to do next. I got my idea after 4 months when I realized that the only thing which I know the best is payments. Because this is what I did last 2 years. And so many clients I met while I was working at ICICI, and they told me that this is a problem statement. So why I'm not doing this? And I think that's how I got into it.
All right. Okay. I'm not going to say anything more. A lot of respect for you, Jiten. Please don't misunderstand. Because what you've done is not, I mean, ridiculous. One, two, three, one after another. Let's go straight into that. So, pehla safalta hai. I think it's Lazy Pay is the first one.
Citrus Pay, online Citrus payment. Pay. Citrus.
Okay. So just a quick understanding. It was all about knowing the customer and the vendor, which you already explained that nobody cares about them enough. It's just simply that idea.
Yeah, simply that idea that let's just give enough love to our customers, show them that we care for them. I think that is good enough. And that is what we did. And of course, in the whole process, we developed the technology way of delivering customer delight and the better service, better reliability and all of that. I think all that is fine. But the number one premise was show to our customers that we care for them. And I think that's what we did day in, day out. And that really worked in our favor.
You know, it's an amazing idea. When you think about it, it's really simple, but it's amazing. I was just thinking about it. We do deal with banks. We do deal with people when we are making payments, and we do get this stalling technique. Yeah, kabhi-kabhi, you know, you don't get a reply or it doesn't come back on time or things are not clear. And then you realize that if you just show a little interest in the consumer and in the vendor, then suddenly, you know, everything changes because they feel somebody cares about them. And then you that's why you have this success. It's just one simple concept. Like you said, technology, of course, backed you after that and everything else. But just that.
Yeah, the philosophies of the business don't change irrespective of what business you are in. You got to care for your clients. You got to care for your customers. You got to care for your team members. And I think that's it.
Okay. So Citrus Pay was the online payment company. You sold that to Naspers in 2016 for the GDP of Bangladesh, from what I gather. And that is why you bought Dalhousie for, you know, one of your cousins just as a friendly payment. Okay, now don't answer these questions because I know it's a little immodest to say anything. And then what happens? See, once you taste success, normally people are, you know, happy with themselves. But you're so young and you still want to do something else.
So that's the thing, right? When you're so young, you can't sit idle. You're like, abhi adrenaline rush back is still left in me. Got to do something. So we joined PayU, the company which acquired us, the Naspers owned company. Which was a competing company to Citrus. So we joined there as an India head and we ran the company for 2.5 years along with my partner Amrish. And we took the company because we had this that, you know, if somebody bought us, we got to justify to them that we were worth it. So, you know, there are two kind of attitude. One is, I got my money, let's wash up my hands, run away. The second attitude is, this guy should say that, wow, this was the best deal I ever did. And that is the attitude we had.
Isn't that the reason why they kept you all there to help steer the ship right direction?
Yeah. So we committed to them that in next 2 years to 2.5 years, we will change the way the PayU is being positioned. We will take the PayU to leadership position. And we did that in 2.5 years.
And you use the word, which is actually correct. I know it's like a funny word, but it's a lazy pay. Because let's face it, we Indians are not the fastest payment providers ourselves. And again, you seem to have tapped in on that. My producer will come and explain that he absolutely loved lazy pay. Because it almost felt like it was too good to be true. Huh?
Yeah. So, you know, when we were in online payments, what we realized, one of the behaviors, when you're making the payment, now that is the most anxious moment which you have, which is, you know, you entered the OTP and you keep praying, hey, my internet should work, nothing should break, my order should get confirmed. And I realized that this is the anxiety I want to take away. And how do you take away? when you separate out the purchase and payment process. So when the purchase, you select your card and you say purchase, the purchase should be completed irrespective of the payment. And you can give the consumer the ability to pay later when they are at ease. So I think that is the innate insight we brought to the table. And we use this behavior of the Kirana store behavior. So Kirana store behavior, what is it? You go to a Kirana store once, twice, thrice, and fourth time, let's say you forget your wallet. The guy says, don't worry, sir, pay me next time.
Huh.
So we said, how do we replicate the same behavior in online world? Where you see the consumer once, twice, thrice, and fourth time, you offer him pay later. And then, which is the lazy pay. And then the guy says, wow, this is a delight. I don't have to worry about my payment when I'm making the purchase, and I can settle the bill anytime during the month. So that's the reason your producer loves this.
No, he's, like you said, they treated him so nicely also. I think that goes back to what you were saying in the beginning, customer's king sort of philosophy, that even though he's wronged the customer in a sense by delaying his payment back, he's still being treated with, you know, tamiz and love and all that, which doesn't generally happen. I remember when I, in the 90s, when it first started, a couple of my friends who tried to buy things and didn't pay on time, they got some really awful calls. In fact, in MTV, we got a guy, two guys came there with long Pathani outfits and all that to chase my, believe it or not, Bakra producer. It was almost like ironical, the whole thing. Anyway, so we need to go to a break and then get Silvery and the EMAs on. Then, Jiten, you founded Jupiter?
Yeah, which is my current venture, Cyrus. So I felt that there's a last startup left in my whole aspiration curve. And I think that is Jupiter. So this startup aspiration is going to be the India's largest financial services franchise. That is the aspiration I'm trying to be. And again, the motivation to do this was that having done payments and having done lending, I realized that all those businesses are still very, very transactional with the consumer. Where is the consumer having real trust and relationship? It is still the bank. And I got to have that relationship with the consumer, which is the deposit relationship. Second, I think today consumers, nobody teaches them about finance. And we as a person in a society where we stay...
market mein finance nahi hai, sir.
But jiske paas paisa kam hai or the aspiration is there that I want to make more money. I want to be financially disciplined. But when you ask around what to do, they say, "Acha, either mutual fund mein dal de, udhar dal de, ye stock khareed le, wo stock khareed le." But there is nobody knows your true financial position, and nobody is able to give you real financial advice. And we want to establish relationship with the consumer where we can give them unbiased advice without the pressure of take this product from me or I want to sell this product to you, but give advice which helps them meet their financial goals. And so bank account is a starting point, but effectively we want to become the day-to-day finance app for the consumer where consumers have a full trust in us that if these guys are helping me meet my goals, so I can trust their advice. And I think that is the situation we want to reach.
I don't know what to say. You know, in just a few years after your ICICI career, you've done a startup which has gone through the roof. Uske baad, you have sold it and actually made the parent company then go through the roof also, which is almost like a second startup. And then you got a third company and you're saying, ki ye mera last hai. I cannot believe it. I think you've got one of those things where till the last breath, you'll not be able to stop yourself. So this
I'm going to run till the last breath. So that's the idea.
Abhi to kehta hai, let's see. I'm sure after 5 years, I'm not saying you'll flip it, but you'll want to do something more. It'll be running on its own, I'm sure. Let's get Silvery in, a big fan of Lazy Pay. He's also a lazy podcaster. Silvery, Antariksh, Abhija, beta, Abhija.
Hello, hi. Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Hi,
very good, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I feel like a terrible customer for Lazy Pay. I would like to apologize just because I have the CEO here. I can just apologize right at the top. I will pay you guys back. Don't worry.
No, but you're like a brand endorsement you've done in a sense. Will you explain the worst customer is still a fan? You get it, which generally doesn't happen.
That's a great thing to absolutely. Hear, man.
Yeah, absolutely.
Like it is literally the. Lazy Pay is such a great name also because it's literally the laziest thing you can do is just click on one thing and you can just make the payment and then think about
it's
later.
It's a super choice of name, Silvery. Yeah. I think because honestly, you feel ki, aaj mujhe nahi banna hai. You know, that kind of it's that voice in your head. It's almost saying, okay, take it, do it better next day.
So you know the backstory is. When we were deciding the name, my team members were telling me, Jiten, don't keep this name. And I'm like, why? You know, they're saying when we will call customers, they're saying today I'm feeling lazy to pay. Please call tomorrow. so my team members are saying, Jiten, customers will use this word against us only and they will not repay. And I'm like, you know, I want to have the name where customers hear it once and they don't forget ever. So that was the whole idea around this name.
Silvery, all pressure tere upar, Sarji, because now at 28, he quit without any idea of what's coming. He just quit and kept quiet and stayed in the room until that, you know, like Buddha moment happens and, you know, led to Nirvana in a sense. But now you're 29.
Yeah, are you telling me I should quit? I should have quit a year
ago. You're 1 year behind. You want to become the next great startup millionaire.
It's inspiring you. Cyrus is inspiring you, man.
I hope people listening. The younger
his show.
No, the younger guys listening should see. Not saying anyone listening. Please don't quit your job. Jiten himself will be telling you, don't quit your job. He himself looks back and says he can't believe he quit his job. From this perspective,
yeah, that was crazy. Crazy moment, exactly. Man. I would not do it again.
Yeah. But it's these mad stories that creates these super successes also. But again, we are saying don't quit your job. This is his story, and not everyone is going to have his karma. So let's. And more than karma, of course, his intellect and entrepreneurial activity, which I, unfortunately, Silver, you and I don't seem to have. So I'm to fast gaye the desk ke piche, laptop samne, same old. And then every time you bring a successful guy like Jiten on, I feel bad about my life for the next 20 minutes. You know, once podcast ends. Absolutely. He's in Himachal in Dalhousie. You know, I mean, and he's still, you know, it's almost like he's been finding a lot of positive happiness during, this is the wrong phrase to use. But like, you know, it's like he's in a good bubble. And you know, other people aren't. Yeah. We are stuck in our lanes. I can't see the building, Sarji. Our basic was gate ban karte hai wo log.
मेरा सेम था फ्रेंकली वो 8 बजे मेरा बिल्डिंग का गेट बंद हो जाता तो आई एम लाइक बस आई एम डन यार आई एम डन आई एम टेकिंग अ फ्लाइट आई एम गोइंग टू अ प्लेस वेयर आई कैन जस्ट आइसोलेट माइसेल्फ बट एटलीस्ट सी द नेचर सो दैट्स हाउ आई डिड इट
And have Wi-Fi. Don't be a lazy payer. You need to make your payments online on time.
Thanks to, I'm not advertising any brand, but thanks to Jio, the life has become so easy from an internet connectivity standpoint. They have done a great job, by the way.
Fair enough. And also, if you had to endorse a brand from your perspective, you might as well join hands with Jio. What else is left here? It's just Jio, Bill Gates, and who do we have? Elon Musk or wo? Taklu ka naam kya hai? With due respect,
Bezos.
Bezos. Yeah. Hopefully, no one will translate that for him. Jiten is enjoying that lack of respect. It's not lack of respect. I forgot, yaar. We all love him. Okay, let's move on. Do we have questions?
Yes, we do. We have quite a lot of questions for Jitendra. He says, first one comes in from Vineet Khandelwal. He says, Citrus Pay is the first payment gateway I ever saw in India. How has UPI affected the business since then?
So in fact, the UPI has actually accelerated the business on online payments. And the reason for that is, see, how internet businesses work and how the online businesses work, where you got more and more consumers coming into the digital fold and digital learning curve. And UPI did a great job by bringing more customers, taught them how to make digital payments. And that automatically increased the behavior of online payments. So in fact, I would give full credit to UPI. In last 3 years, all digital businesses, all online payments businesses have actually tripled in last 3 years. So tripled. Due credit to them. That's true.
Wow. But we are in the wrong business here, Silvery. You have to first check whether track record is good. Like pandemic mein pharmacy. And online, obviously, activity like this. But really, please think of an idea of 28 or 29.
I tell you what. My problem is that I'm always late to everything because people, everyone
second
around
idea,
me.
No. You can't have the lazy pay idea second. That's of no use.
Also, for instance, my friends were all telling me for the last couple of months, invest in crypto. I finally did. And then the market crashed. I'm in 20% loss. It's insane. This is sad.
Since you mentioned it,
Stay put.
Stay put. Thank you. Yes, financial expert telling me what to do. That makes sense. Awesome.
Lazy investment. That's the next idea that's coming to me. Crypto, abhi baith jao. Aur kuch na karo. Just leave it. Yeah. But since you mentioned, Jiten, are these bitcoins and these crypto and all, are they here to stay and can we take them more seriously? Middle class India is still scared.
I would say it's better to be scared. So, say, boss, he has done a mistake. I don't want him to do another mistake. So I'm like, you have done a mistake, stay put. By selling, you might do another mistake because what might happen, 2 months down the line, it will be 40% up and you say, oh shit, Jiten advised me to sell. And is another mistake I did because of Jiten. He will say in the show. I don't want him to say on the show.
Silly, I think it's like having an ugly child and then you say you don't get rid of the child. You keep the child, but don't keep a second child. I think that's what he's saying. Chal, go to the next one.
Yeah. So, Vineet, the person who had just asked the previous question, he has another question which kind of puts Jitendra on the spot. He says, AMA at Jitendra, are you looking for a back-end engineer? I think he's handing in his resume.
Yeah. Please send it on my LinkedIn. I will respond for sure.
Oh, okay. No, wow.
Back-end engineer for his what he's setting up in Dalhousie, which is not exactly the same thing as all these startups. Huh? You must be getting a lot of people interested in working for you, people who follow your career or just follow, you know, startups. Everybody wants a
deal. Yeah, so in a week, I must be receiving 400 to 500 resumes.
My God.
Wow.
Such batao, sir. Tu kya karega? I mean, how can you can't answer 400?
So I don't, right? That's what I'm saying, Vineet. I'll respond for sure, my promise.
Oh, wow. Vineet, that's lucky.
Okay, yeah. But it doesn't mean you're getting a job. It just means he's responding. Yeah. Oh, he's saying nice, is it?
Nice.
Vineet, if you spell like that, you'll get the job for sure, yaar. Itna lazy speller. From the same family, you know, lazy speller bhi nikal gaya.
Okay, right. Next one comes in from Kashin Shetty. He says, hello, Jitendra sir. Do you feel that the concept of paying later might unintentionally lead people to overspending, like with credit cards? How do you educate people to spend wisely?
So frankly, you don't get credit card. That's why you do pay later product. So pay later is generally for people who don't have access to credit cards. So in fact, it keeps them honest in spending, because there is a very limited line which they get to spend. So you know you're not going to overspend. That being said, I can't help if there's no self-discipline. So
yeah, it's a human nature point.
It's a self-discipline still needs to be there in terms of budgeting your finances. Otherwise, irrespective of pay later or not pay later, you're going to get into debt trap.
And also how we think depends on our parents a lot and background, I think, a little bit. Like Silvery, you young guys, some of you all, I think you all don't even understand. You just look at brands and say, wow. But I was brought up, my dad gave me 30 bucks pocket money for 10 years. It never changed, you know. So I used to really, every rupee used to be valued. Literally, when we were drinking for the first time, just getting that beer, we would share it with vodka so that it goes more. In that 30 rupees, we could get more alcohol out of it. So one quart vodka with beer. I think for some reason, Jiten has started drinking because he's just moving all over the place. Can't see. Jito, are you there?
Sorry, Jitendra, yeah, I think you lost your audio.
You're there. Okay.
Yeah, cool.
Sorry.
I was on mute. Sorry.
Okay. Cool.
He wants to mute us actually, but he's being nice. Concept of how much you spend and all, I think it background and all plays a very important role. Next.
Sure. Next one is an entrepreneurial kind of question. Janil asks, what was your toughest day till date? What happened the day on the day, and how did you bounce back from it, if you remember? I know it's a tough thing to recall.
You know, in startup life, it's a tough thing to recall. The reason I would say in startup life, you go through the toughest days very, very often. So it is not like one or two or three, which you can count on fingers. You must be going through those kind of moments every month. That being said, I think the one which I can recall, I still remember distinctly. It was in December of 2013. 12 or 13, one of those years. It was in December. We were having one of our largest client issue, and it was contributing almost 30% of our revenue. We lost that client on one single day because of one of our mistake. And I'm like, man, and actually it was more than 30%, maybe 40% revenue. And we just lost the client in one single day. And we just did not know what to do next, how to get it back. Because, you know, getting that kind of growth back in next 6 months also, we did not have the visibility. So then I personally went to the client, paawa pakde uske, apology mangi, promised everything I will do myself. I think it took us 2 months to get the client back. But it was like a real hard 2 months for us to meet all the demands, to meet all the things which we had to do to give the confidence back to the client. And I think from there it was not looking back, because we learned our lesson hard way that way. But yeah, that was the day I still remember. And
those responsible frankly, for the mistake.
Those responsible for the mistake, of course, they had their fair share of hearing, but but yeah, it was tough.
But they weren't dropped from the company.
No, they weren't dropped from the company. I think these are the last things we will do. Frankly, we will drop people only if there is an attitude issue in the work.
This is very Indian, I think. You know, I only Indian entrepreneurs think like this. This humane factor where every ek parivar ho jate almost, and you don't take action. Yeah. Can you hear us?
So we will not drop anyone. Yeah.
Okay, the sound is coming. Yeah, it's going
very difficult.
We'll wrap up in 3-4 minutes. Anything? Don't worry. Hello?
Okay. Yeah. So
you want to?
Yeah,
you want to stop?
No, I can hear you, Cyrus.
Okay, you can hear us. I thought you had a chance to say, no, you can't hear us.
Also, it's not like those employees must have done it on purpose, right? They always made a mistake.
That's right.
You lose 40% of your revenue. Somebody's head will roll. In the West, they would have been gone. In America, they would have been gone in 2 minutes. There's no question. Right, Jiten?
I mean,
depends on company to company, I would say.
It depends. Yeah, it depends. On the founder, it depends on the management and how what kind of culture you have and all of that, right? So, but it is a time actually which brought us together, I would say, as a team, because we sort of had a better bonding that way. I would say that this was when I look back now, I think this was the best time we had, that we had the challenge to solve, and we did it together.
Are the client and you still friends?
Oh yeah, very good friends. So now, of course, we never gave them a chance to have the same complaint. But all now industry guys, good friends, hang out together.
Up to Jiten is the top of the heap here. It's a different thing. That time he was still early days in the company. Chalo, can we squeeze one or two more before the audio goes? Yes, and Jiten, what is that next to your ears? We are seeing these trinkets. Something, the small
these
squares.
Lanterns.
Actual or ornamental?
Background?
These are actual lanterns.
Wow. Oh. To scale, huh? Chilori? To scale. That's his next venture, I think. Lazy lantern. Chalo. Next.
Okay.
All right. Jitendra, are you into cricket by any chance?
Oh, yeah, I follow it.
Okay, cool. So Harvesh Kasad asks, hello all, after the impressive performance in one-off test match, do you see Indian women cricket team winning the ODI and T20 series in England?
Well, they lost the first. Now you have to ask him if he's interested in women's cricket also.
Yeah,
I thought
you would ask. You said cricket, but that didn't mean women's cricket. So though you know, I read about the performance, the last performance, and that was like phenomenal. But I have no views on future, frankly. I don't follow women's cricket.
Jiten, Indian women were a bit lazy, to use your phrase. Lost the first one-day game just day before yesterday, quite badly to England. So I think he's asking about the one-day and T20 series. I think only he and Harvesh and me are the only two who follow. properly follow the male and female team because we have no
work. I'm sorry, I'm not following this.
Yeah. No, I think we'll do better in the one day and T20 series, but I think England will beat us in all three forms in England because of the conditions. And their women are quite, I don't want to sound, this should not be politically incorrect, but they're quite large and strong. Silvery, would you like to comment on that?
you are objectifying. Don't get into
it. I'm looking at it from a sporting point of view, a scientific point of view, Jitin. Please don't get me wrong. My wife is 10 feet away. I would not dare mention all these things. They're all feminists in my house. Both maar khayega main. I will not do that. I'm just saying that they're bigger built than our girls. And okay. You know, they use their sort of muscle, more muscle in these conditions where they can get the ball to swing and bounce, which they're doing. That's all. Let's leave that conversation and move back to digital banking.
Payment next apps. One. Next
much
one.
Safer.
Next one. Yeah, next one. Question. This is Goiko Rohan asks, Indian B team is in Sri Lanka right now. Any possibilities if the three Sri Lankan players sent back from England for breaching the bubble rules will get to play at home?
Yeah, I think they'll.
These are out of syllabus for me, frankly.
<It's out.
laughs> Yeah, I'll give a short answer to that. The three of them in Durham after the England T20s, they went out. They broke the curfew, but you just mentioned how you couldn't take it in Bombay, you know, shutting the gates, all of us are going through, and that's why you're in Dalhousie. You have to understand, I think that people can, they're on tour somewhere else in a foreign country, they're bored, they have to be sent back to the room for hours at a time, play a game, then back in the room. So these three guys went for a walk. And of course, Sri Lankans are like Indians. Some fan came. Fan said, Niloshan! Oh, wicketkeeper, let's take a picture. Took a picture, put it on Insta. That's all. And you know, you put it on Insta, the guy's career is over. So while the management thought they're all in the room sleeping, these three guys gumawing in the city are caught on camera, put on Insta, and whole of Sri Lanka knows. So action had to be taken because they breached the bubble. That's all there is to it. But I have a lot of sympathy for this bubble breaching. I think it's just madness here. You can't just sit
like this and... It's like the same that Rohit Sharma went for lunch out
exactly.
with a couple of guys in a restaurant.
In Australia, yeah. I mean, how can you not expect them to, yaar? What do you want them to do? What kind of life is it sitting in the... everybody can't afford Dalhousie with Lalten. You go where you can.
Yeah, man. That's a... Okay.
Okay, okay. We'll squeeze one last one. Don't worry. I know it's tough. It's tough for him. We'll squeeze one. Uh-oh. And speaking of Lalten, did you see what happened, guys?
Yeah.
God has blessed us. The Bijli has gone.
See?
Oh, wow.
But the Bijli will come back.
But it's okay.
The Bijli will come back.
Still, yeah.
It'll take a few seconds, but it will come back. Or it'll take a little longer. Anyway, Silvery, carry on. Let's get one more in. I don't want to lose Jitin. Give him at least 2 minutes more and then we'll quit.
Okay, sure. So there are no real questions, but there are some comments here. So I'll just read the comments.
Yeah, I'm just lighting up myself.
Aditya Bhuskute asks, hi Jitendra, you seem a very humble person. How do you keep yourself on your feet?
Boss, life mein enough enough mark hai hai. So I've learned enough that the good times and bad times are like together. So I've seen enough of bad times also. So I think whenever I feel extra proud, I just remember that how you can fall off from the heights. So it's better to stay grounded. That's the best way.
You should ask me the same question also, no, Silvery? Although the difference in income must be what some...
Yeah, okay. Cyrus, you seem like a very humble person. How do you keep yourself on your feet?
See, my problem is basically we don't have electricity, khana, peena, basic amenities are... So when you don't have basic amenities, you know, you can't afford to not be humble because you know that you're living in a slum, basically. Yeah. God, now they're shutting everything around me. I don't know if the government is listening. What's going on? Yeah. Okay. Anyway, Jitin, this has been a real pleasure. Sorry that we are ending with all these third world problems. But you've been a great inspiration. I'm sure people listening will take a lot from you. And thank you so much for giving us time from your very busy schedule. Now about
thanks,
the 10 million
enjoyed.
Ek aur baat hai, wo $10 million US dollars we'll talk offline as our initial startup investment for our पॉडकास्ट
वो जो जो शेयर ट्रांसफर करना था वो वाला ना.
हाँ जी बिटकॉइन भी दे दो.
या
कूल ऑलराइट ओके बाय गाइस
बाय बट ग्रेट ग्रेट चैटिंग गाइस. थैंक्स थैंक्स
थैंक यू जितिन. आवर प्लेजर. बाय.